lunch going to be ready?
As soon as I make these sandwiches for the kids.
Well, I'm starving. I don't know if I can hold on that long. Hey, how are you kids coming along with that tent?
We can't figure this thing out. The instructions are crazy, that's for sure.
It's not supposed to look like this, is it?
No, it's supposed to look like an igloo.
I want a melted igloo.
Dad, can we go fishing now? We'll never get this thing up.
Listen, just wait a minute and I'll be over and I'll help you put it up in a second. Let me just get through with this fire pit here. Now, where's Michael? Isn't he supposed to be giving you a hand?
Yeah, he was, but he was kind of getting in the way, so I told him to go help Mom with something.
Well, I asked him to go down to the creek and get some water.
Okay.
Please watch over them at the lake. Amen.
Amen.
You've been messing up lately. It's probably the other way.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go.
Who wants lunch first? Girls?
Oh, get away from me.
Knock it off.
Come on, you guys. I always have a warm sandwich when I go fishing.
Sure, then you eat it.
Right now.
How about Michael? Hey, Michael, do you want it? What was that? I think it was a coyote or something? Maybe it was Big Feet.
How about you, Michael? You want to go, don't you?
The chickens have lips.
How about you, Pete? You want to go, don't you? You're not scared, are you?
I'll look for a little while. I want to get back and do some more fishing.
Great. Let's go.
I can't believe you guys are going out there.
Yeah. Why don't we just go back to camp?
We can fish tomorrow.
Don't worry, you guys. We'll be back in a few minutes, and maybe we'll bring you some coyote burgers.
Yeah.
Huh. What if it is a coyote? What if he comes after us?
Jump in the water. Coyotes hate water.
Yeah, but there's fish in there.
Yeah. have teeth like coyotes do. Something. Oh, man. We might as well give up. There's nothing around here.
Hey, what's that over there?
That's Jeb Miller's old place. He was an old hermit. That's why they call this Miller's Woods. But he died a few years ago.
Let's go take a look.
Good idea. Come on.
That thing's right outside.
Yeah, whatever it is.
I sure wish I was fishing right now.
You and me both.
What if it tries to get in here?
I just hope that door holds it.
Boy, this place is really falling apart.
Yeah. Try to find a board or something to hit that thing with in case it tries to bust in.
Let's get out of here.
Oh, Pete, wait a minute. Somebody's hurt.
Oh, Karen, come on.
doing here?
How do you know my name?
Well, you work at the library, and we go in there all the time to get stuff for school.
Yes, I recognize you now.
Do you live up here or something?
Only on weekends. I come for peace and quiet.
Wait a minute. Was that you making all those weird noises?
Weird noises?
You know, howling noises.
Well, Yes. It was me. It was so stupid. I hope I didn't scare you. I don't know what came over me.
You didn't scare us that much. But why'd you do it?
It's a long story. I was trying to write a story about wolves. I couldn't get any ideas. I don't know anything about wolves. So I thought maybe if I could make wolf sounds, I could watch and see how people reacted when they thought a wolf was around, and then I'd have something to write. Does that make any sense?
I don't know. I guess.
No, it doesn't. It's just plain stupid, like everything else I do.
You're not stupid.
Yes, I am. People have been telling me I am for as long as I can remember. And I was going to show them by writing a book. A bestseller. And that it'd show. I'm going to give your kids some good advice. Don't ever keep on telling anyone that they're stupid or they're no good or they can't ever do anything right. Because pretty soon they're going to believe you. I'm sorry, I don't know why I'm telling you all this.
Wait a minute, Mr. Richards. You might not think you're much, but we do. You're about the most helpful person that library has ever had.
Yeah. Why do you think we always come to you when we want to find stuff?
And I'll tell you someone else who thinks you're about the most special person in the whole world.
Yeah? Who?
Jesus.
Oh.
Jesus loves you so much, he even died on the cross for you. And for me too. Because he wants us all to have eternal life.
Well, when someone loves you that much, well, it makes you feel different about yourself.
And it makes you act different towards other people, too.
Jesus. I haven't thought about him in a long while. Quite a long while.
All over here pointing to the lake.
Honey, let's try this way.
Hey, wait a minute. You're not giving up, are you?
I guess I am. Wait a minute.
What's going on?
Just hold still.
Is there something out there?
Keep quiet. Get down. Come on, get down.
What is it?
It's a Harold something.
Are you kidding me?
Are you sure it's him?
They showed his picture on TV last night. It's him, trust me. What's the matter with you kids? Aren't you scared?
Sure we're scared.
But it sure does help to know that Jesus is with us.
Yeah.
Miller's place is down there. I can find my way from there. Come on.
Oh, no! Michael.
Huh? It's the rest of our Crucio gang.
Can't wait.
Get back.
Please.
Go.
Go over there, guys. Hey, there's a guy over there. Maybe he sees it on a page. Hey, mister!
That was a gunshot.
Somebody if your trap hadn't caught him.
He did?
You probably saved somebody's life.
I don't know. I never thought about it that way.
And we should thank you too, Michael.
Me?
What for? If you hadn't yelled and scared off Harold Blake, he might have tried to hide out in the house.
Who knows what might happen then?
Thanks. There's nothing, actually.
Woods, yes.
Did you say something?
Yes. I think I just got an idea for a story. A better story. It's all about this escaped convict who hides out in an old house in the woods. And every time people get too close, he howls like a wolf and chases them away. That way nobody'd ever find him.
That's great.
See, we told you could do it.
Well, maybe I can. Things.